Hello, my name is Victoria and you are on my sewing channel. Some of you were asking me to show how I made the thongs that you guys saw in my very first video. There I was showing you how to make a cool bralette with different adjustable strap elastics. And if you're interested in this thematic and haven't seen this video yet, I will link this somewhere here. Especially for you girls, I bought some extra strap elastics to make this project done, and finally you can finish your set. So this is what we are going to do today. I was inspired by one lingerie brand called Atelier Bordel. I believe that they are making very interesting and unique things, and this is my variation on one of their panties. The final look of thongs we will make today will be a little bit different. For instance, I will use fold over elastic to finish the edges, and everything will be a little bit more accurate. There are two layers of the fabric from the front, the upper one attached to the ring and elastics, and the lower one attached to the gusset. On the back there are six loops with rings. And cool thing about these thongs that you can play with the height of these side elastics and creating very different look. In this way it looks a little bit like a spider on the back, especially in the black color. Well, six-legged spider. So for this project I will use black elastic mesh. I believe it is the best fabric choice in this case. Then a small piece of a thin jersey for the gusset. I used elastic that is used for shoulder straps. Very important thing, it should be a thin shoulder strap elastic. Here is an example of a perfect choice. And you need lots of it. I used 2.70 m for my XS size. As I mentioned earlier, I will use this time fold over elastic, and I believe this is the best choice. Then we will need 6 rings the same size as your elastic. In my case it is 1 cm. And 1 ring that is slightly bigger for the center. And we will need 6 sliders too. Then as usual, thin synthetic threads, number 150 or 120. You should have special needles for stretchy materials. The first one number 65 or 75 and the second one number 90 to work with elastics and thick places. And basically that's all. This is a thong pattern I built long ago. I would say it's something in between low and middle waist, and you take thong pattern you have. Now I will show you how to make some changes. I have already moved all the lines to another paper so that it is comfortable for me to cut it out later. I will start from the front piece. At the beginning I will draw this place on the panties where mesh stops and straps start. I measure on the top edge a distance of 10 cm from the center and draw down a straight line with a slight angle. And now on this line, from the top corner, I measure down length of 2 straps, in my case 2 cm. And then I smooth the leg line to this point. Then I need to make a slight bend of my upper cut up to 1 cm. My pattern originally doesn't have this bend, so I'm doing this to give enough room for the central strap with the ring, otherwise it will not look good. Okay, lower layer is done. I will draw the upper detail that looks like a triangle. So from the upper central point I draw a line at 45 degrees. Now we have on our drawing 2 layers of fabric. Lower layer comes only to the gusset and upper one comes to the back seam. I will outline them in 2 different colors. Now I'm going to show you the back side. I marked a point 3 cm from the center and draw down a line with a slight angle. As you can see, there are 3 straps, 3 loops, that connect to this point. Each 1 cm, so 3 cm in total. I make a mark and smooth the lower edge to this point. The last step is to slightly bend the upper edge and it's ready. Now about seam allowances. I will use fold over elastic, so I will give allowances only in the joints of the elastics and the gusset, so 1 cm and 7 mm accordingly. These are all the details of the pattern. I cut them with seam allowances and they should go like this, on the top and the back one. So, now about elastics. If you are familiar with modeling of lingerie, you would already be able to calculate the length of the elastics. But I will especially focus my attention on this point and try to explain as clear as possible. Well, let only one of us suffer. On our thongs, we have 6 loops with rings. I cut 6 times 4 cm of elastic. Then we have places of connections of seam allowances and straps that we will cover. I cut 4 times 8 cm. This length is enough for me to wrap around. You always can cut a longer piece and then trim this in the end. And now about straps from the sides. When I was making these first red thongs, I made them a little bit too short. I forgot that strap elastic has a low elasticity. To avoid this mistake, we need to measure our hips on the place where usually our thong sits. Then we will need to subtract our front detail to the seam allowance and our back detail with seam allowance and another 1 cm of the loop, well, basically to the ring. Okay, you get some number. Now you need to add 2 cm to secure the slider and another 5 cm for the ease. Well, you do not want that your slider be exactly near the ring. Pay attention that your upper strap goes from the ring on the back to the ring on the front. So for the upper elastic, you don't need to subtract the front part, though give it few centimeters extra to adjust in the end the center. I will write you down in the description box all the calculations and also how long I cut my elastics for my hip measurements. And finally, we are going to our sewing machine. The first step is to connect our front piece with a gusset. I position my gusset with the right side to the wrong side of my front detail. I pin the edge and make a temporary hand stitch. I make a straight stitch on my sewing machine and then I remove my hand stitch. After this, I go and iron my seam allowance. I do not show you this step because it's very ordinary. At first you iron your seam allowance flat and then you position and iron the seam allowance to the front. I trimmed my seam allowance to 5 mm in the end. The next step is tricky, so pay attention. Now our front piece faces us with the wrong side. We cover it with the back piece of the thongs, right side towards us. And then we cover them with a front triangle piece, wrong side towards us. I pinned the edge and made a hand stitch as earlier, and now when we unfold everything, we get a closed back seam. After this, I stitched, trimmed, and ironed my seam allowance. Now we need to stitch our fold-over elastic to the upper edges of our thongs. I usually leave some small elastic tail at the beginning. It's easier to start to stitch. You do not need to stretch your fold-over elastic if it's as firm as mine. It should lay straight. If your elastic is more wiggly and agile, you give a slight stretch just to avoid waves. With the front triangle piece, we are doing like this. We are stitching to the top center and then we are stitching for another 4 cm. The same from another side. We are going to the top and then we are merging our elastics together. Later we will need this tail to secure the ring. Before stitching my elastics to the side cuts, I need to hand stitch all the pieces like this. Then nothing will shift and I easily can remove this stitch later. If there are some uneven cuts, just trim all the excess. Okay, sides are done and now we can switch our needle to a thicker one. It is time of our loops. I put on the ring and sew our loops to the seam allowances. I gave 1 cm of seam allowances on my thongs and 1 cm on my loops. It is easier to hand stitch all of these at first and then to make a zigzag on our sewing machine and to remove the hand stitch. Then we will close this place like this. This small tail I position from the bottom and cover this with a strap. You definitely need to hand stitch this detail. And look how thick this place is. That's why you need a thicker needle. I need to make a straight stitch 1 mm from the edge. I start in the thickest place, make a back stitch and go all the way around. I make a frame. Usually with this type of work I use a hand wheel. Like this I can control my stitching. Well, seems accurate. The next step is to put on our sliders on the straps and secure them with a straight stitch or a zigzag stitch. I pull my elastic through the ring and then the second time through the slider, like this with all of them. After this, I need to hand stitch my elastics to the front seam allowances. Well, at the step I somehow twisted around my thongs in a very weird way and noticed this almost at the end. It was a mess to fix it, so pay attention that everything were where it have to be. I make my mistakes so you don't have to make yours. After hand stitching, I cover this knot with our elastic. The upper strap I stitch instantly to the cover elastic. I marked with a chalk the place where it have to be. And after this, as on the back side, I make a straight stitch 1 mm from the edge and stitch a frame. We almost done. We slide our 3 middle elastics into the ring. I pin them first and try the thongs on my body. Like this I can adjust all these straps. But usually when it lies down on the flat surface in the beautiful way, it also sits good on your body. You actually can stitch close to the ring. I just left myself some room in the case I want to change something. And it's done. You can't even imagine how cool they sit on the body, and they are so comfortable. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of this content, and you can always write down in the comments what sewing tutorial you would like to see. And let me know if you are going to make these thongs. kisses to all of you, and I see you very, very soon.